Welcome back to Farming Simulator 2015 with the Rude Man. We are farming. Let's go check it out. All right, what were we doing here? What are you doing? Oh, I was gonna start mowing this, but I think I'll wait on that. Kind of wait a little bit. Let's see, where are we at here? We were doing some of that stuff. Oh, yeah, we were working on trailers. Working on trailers, but I don't remember doing what. Let's see, we got this guy that was getting silage. We were going to sell silage, were we? All right, so what's the deal with the silage here? Let's see. Brief time biomass heating is ready to pay a considerably higher price for silage. View the statistics for more information. That's where I was headed, so let's see where that is. Shipping office, biomass. So it's right close by. It is. Whoa! I got a heavy load here. I got a lot of silage on this load here. Oh, the truck's got 52% damage on it. The dolly's got 13%. I damaged it getting it hooked up, I think. All right, so we're getting close to the biomass. Just on the other side. Ooh, jeez. Oh, I forgot I turned cars on. Oh, I forgot all about that. Is that my truck in the parking lot there? I'm just assuming these trailers are working well. They're not really silage trailers, they're grain trailers, but if I can hit the trigger, I'll be okay. Let's see how this is gonna work. Did I hit a trigger yet? Give me a trigger. Come on. Oh, if I have to back up, I'm gonna be in trouble. Oh man. What's happening? Oh, am I gonna have to hit that right inside there? If I am, that's gonna be a bummer because hooking these trailers up was a pain in the patoot. Oh, geez, this thing's, oh man, he's got a heavy load. We may have a problem here. Yeah, Houston, we got an issue. Well, let me see if I can get closer to that trigger. If not, I may have to dump this stuff. Oh, that's not going to be easy either. How are these things tracking? Okay? Yeah, I guess so. Oh, man. I wish it had a grate. I'm afraid I'm going to have to back into that thing to sell the product. Oh, man. I hit it. Oh, I don't think I can get in close enough. I don't know where the trigger's at. Wait a minute, I got a trigger. Okay. I guess I could look. Yeah, I really can't. Well, let's see. Oh, look how it goes down. Interesting. That's cool. Now, the problem is that second trailer coming in close enough? I don't think it is, but because I don't think I can get far enough forward to get that other trailer lined up with the trigger. See, I'm hitting the building. Oh, man. This is not going to be fun. All right, well, let's see. I'm trying to get stay to the left as much as I can, or as far as I can. Oh, I didn't hit the other trigger. And I don't think I'm gonna. Oh, no. I don't see any way of doing it. Alright, let's get back out of here. It's gonna be a rough ride home because he's got all the weight in the rear trailer. Which is never good. It's a recipe for jackknifing. And I think I'll be okay going back because the silage pit, the storage for the silage is a grate, so I can drive across that as long as I didn't park anything on top of the grate, like one of the things, either thing one or thing two. Or another trailer. Oh, I didn't realize I was that far away from it. Let's go out this way and then schwang around this way. And see if I can hit that grate with the back trailer. I'm gonna have the same issue, aren't I? Man, I'm gonna have the same problem hitting that grating with the back trailer. Did that get it? All right, so now I'm gonna have to, let's see, did I have those new trucks set up on a trigger or a, yeah, did I? Oh, what am I doing here? Was I purchasing? I must have been. I have new animals. Okay, so we got this guy. It was such a pain in the butt to hook the other dolly up that I'm afraid. Well, I got him hooked up, and I realized that there's a dolly made for these trailers. So let me get in. I can't do that. I'll go get the other trailer and use that. But here's what I'm talking about. On another map, I realized, I think one of the other maps that I'm playing now, I realized that there is a dolly. Okay, so I had a couple of where am I? Okay, let's do this. Okay, these two trailers I got from one mod site. Okay, so they're grain trailers, black and white. All right, so Wilson trailers. Then from another site, I got these trailers, which is a 36 foot, a pup trailer, black, both black and white, two pup trailers, And then I have a tandem trailer. This tandem trailer is not a trailer. It's a dolly that goes with the pup trailers. So you take this dolly and you hook it up to this pup trailer, and then you hook it up to one of these 36-foot trailers, and you've got, you know, dual trailers, a 36-footer and a pup trailer. These grain trailers are 45-footers right here. They're meant to be single trailers. Okay, so I didn't really need the dollies, not for those trailers. I forget how fast these trucks go. So the trailers that I'm using are the 45 footers. They're not meant to run tandem. They're meant to be a single trailer, which is fine. That's fine. But now I have trailers that I don't really, well, I don't know, really, I really don't know what to do with them. Mirrors don't work in these trucks. But boy, do the backup lights, they work really well. Am I on the wrong side of the... What? Do these not hook up? Oh my god. There. I'm going to be doing a little damage to those things. I think once I get these things hooked up, I'm not taking them off. Okay, so here's the thing. Do I keep the 45 footers or do I get the 36 in the pup trailer? At this point, I don't know. So I can actually sell two of the trailers back. One thing about it, they don't have any trouble pulling these single trailers. When you see a set of doubles on the road, they're generally 26 foot. That's what I used to run. Two 26-foot trailers with a dolly in between them. And you don't see 45-footers hooked in tandem. You just don't. Well, maybe you do now, but you didn't back then. Right, now what's going on? I'm not close enough. So I'm going to have to do this. Till I hit a trigger. If I hit a trigger before I hit the building. Are you kidding? Well, all right, I'm gonna have to get closer. Did it with the other truck. These trucks turn slow. I gotta crank the wheel about 10 minutes before it starts to turn. Alright, now I gotta try to get in there as close as I can without hitting anything and stay as close as I can for the longest period of time that I can. There we go. All right, now, let's see, is this, do we have this truck It is. It's in group four. So, what? 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 What's going on here? Let's see, I bought two of these and two of the Kenworths. They're all Kenworths, all four of them. But where am I in relation to the farm? Was I coming from... All right, I was coming from the dealer. I still like that. This is still my favorite truck. I like those other Kenworths, but they don't have mirrors at work. At least not on my farm. And all of these trucks have 700 horsepower. Okay, so now I've got a trailer at the dealership. I came over here to get that other trailer, didn't I? I sure did. So let's park this guy for the time being. Not in the telephone pole, but... And then let's go get our animals and bring them home. See, these Kenworths, they drive okay, but the mirrors don't work. So it's kind of hard to drive it on the inside like this because you can't really see whether things are tracking or not. Now I got to deal with that traffic. I didn't remember that I did that. I think I turned it on for another map that I'm playing and I forgot. Now, let's see, we've got cattle. I wanted to replenish what was going on here, so let's see what is going on. We've got cattle. Okay, wait, go back. Okay, beef one has 33 young animals, 38 in beef two. Beef three has 18. Okay. So I need to go to beef three. All right, there's beef two. Beef three. You have to go outside of the truck to do this because one, the mirrors don't work, and the other, I can't see through the back of the truck. But that's okay, I couldn't see through the back of the trailer either. Alrighty, let's drop these and then we'll go back. This one is empty. I don't know how long the sale goes, and I don't know how much of the silage I should sell. I've got quite a bit because I've still got the silage that I'm picking up out of the bunkers. So I could probably sell everything I've got stored and still be okay. Woo! I gotta call my insurance company, make sure my insurance is paid up. him go to work. Let's see about this fella. Okay, let's... Alright, let's see. We've got 4 trailers and 4 trucks. Yeah, we do. So, let's drop the rear trailer. What do we got on this one? What is on this one? Okay, yeah, this one that doesn't show because they're not meant to be tandem. So, let's see. That's the front trailer. That's the dolly. That's the rear trailer. Front trailer. Dolly. Let's unhook from the dolly. That means we kept the dolly. We didn't keep the dolly. Okay, I screwed up. That's okay. Let's just move this guy around. Get him lined up. And then let's go to the garage. These dollies that I bought are not the right dollies. Because if I'm going to use these trailers, they come with their own dolly. And they're not made for the 45 footers, so there you go. But I'm going to go ahead and sell these because I'm not going to use them. And then since I have 4 trucks, I'll keep the 4 trailers. And at some point, I may change my mind and trade the 45 footers in for 2 pup trailers and 2 of the 36 trailers and see how those work. They might work better for when I'm doing the harvest. Fortunately, it's not too bad because my fields are close to the farm. So I'm really not having to drive miles and miles and miles from the farm back to the to dump the crops. But then again, if you remember on Graceland, in the 4 corners of the map are other silos that I can dump to and not have to drive clear back to my farm. So just having 1 45 foot trailer instead of 2 tandem trailers might be just fine. I gotta remember to watch for traffic now. I could probably automate this, but this isn't something I'm gonna be doing a lot of, I don't think. Because if I start doing silage for sale, I'll probably start working it at the biogas plant itself instead of doing it from my farm. All right, I got close enough. I forgot to look, see how much money I'm making. And I'm assuming the sale is still going. Never assume, I suppose. Chuck it. Let's chuck it. Okay, great demand. Yep, still going. All right, so what do we got here? Let's get this one hooked up to this one. Now, I wonder if this one hooks up better to these trailers than that other one. Because this one actually, the fifth wheel part looks lower to the ground than the other trucks. But I'm not sure that's correct either. Looks can be deceiving. Yeah, see, that goes under a lot easier. So my favorite truck actually works better. You know, that's not supposed to ride that high. They're supposed to ride right on there. So that's not right, but oh well. Can't be perfect. Yeah, see what I'm saying is, if I sell everything I've got stored, I'll still be fine because I've got 4 bunkers full of silage. You know, the animals aren't going to eat that much, I don't think. So I might as well make some money while there's a sale going. That's my thought. I'm almost to 1 million buckaroonies. Oh, I'm gonna hit that pole. Doggone it. I gotta get my other truck, get it out of the way. Go back and buy some more animals. Almost took that one a little too wide. I hope there's no traffic coming. It doesn't appear that the traffic's too bad on this map, really. Whee! Kind of leave the ground there. Since I don't know how long the sale's gonna go, I'm gonna keep working on this for a minute. Oh, that didn't look good. There we go. Yeah, I just love this truck. I just really do. It's smooth sounding, it's smooth driving. It's got mirrors that function. Although, I just realized in another episode of a different map that the mirrors don't match up there. The glass doesn't match up with the frame of the mirror. So, you know, oh well, it functions. Guess that's the important part. It's just nice to have mirrors, that's what I think. Alright, see if we can hug this building tight enough to get in and hit this trigger. Now, I screwed up. I should have waited on driving that one into the place and filled this one up. Well, he's empty already. So we're 1,100,000. Good deal. This truck does actually drive smoother than those other Kenworths. Now I'm using a wheel, and that's what I'm talking about. On the other one, I turned the wheel quite a little bit before the truck turns. On this one, when I turn the wheel, the truck moves. So this one works better with the wheel. Now, granted, that other one drives faster, but I don't know if speed's an issue on this map. I think I'm gonna come around from the backside this time. Now here's what I should have done last time. Pull this truck forward. Get the next truck in line. And get him loading. While I'm unloading. Oh shoot, I didn't drop. Oh well, just barely. So, what do we do on this episode? Hey, we sold silage. That's about it. Well, I don't know how much silage we have. Yeah, now look. Okay, watch. I'm turning the wheel, but the truck isn't really turning. Just real slow. And I'm still turning my wheel. This one does not drive as good as that other one does. I don't know if it's not handling the load and it's like hydroplaning. Oh, did I? What was that? Oh my God. How'd that happen? Oh, I got some damage on my trailer. Oh, and I'm stuck on the fence. I really am. I'm really stuck on the fence. Oh, no. No, no, no. Let me off. Let me off. Let me off. Oh, geez. How much damage did I do? 18%. See, I don't think that would have happened with the other truck because I don't have the trouble steering it as I'm having with this one. I think what I'm going to do, I like these trucks, I like them a lot, but I like that other one better. I might swap these out for four of those. Now, this one didn't seem to float like that other one did. Maybe the other one goes faster. And when I hit that bump, it flies off of it a little easier. I don't know. But like I said, I don't need this thing to go that fast, really. I've had this mod for a long time. Matter of fact, I think this is the first truck mod that I got. Traffic. Anything else? Yes. Don't hit me. Don't hit me. Whoa, that was close. Well, that's a good thing about not having mirrors. I didn't have to look back and see that I was getting hit in the trailer by a car. What I don't know won't hurt me, I guess. All right, let's see what kind of silage we have left here. Let's see. Silage. Oh, I don't know if it shows, actually. That'll show. We still have quite a bit, I think. Or, well, it's hard to tell. Let's get this guy on the road. Coming up on $2 million. Woohoo. Silage is good business. What do we got on that? Ah, wow. That's a lot of silage. A lot of silage. More traffic. I could have probably made that, but yeah, never know. Better safe than sorry, I suppose. Now, see, the problem is, I don't know how long that sail's gonna last. It didn't really say. It said for a short time, I think, that there was an extra price on silage, but I should make sure and see if it's still there. Flegel. Yep, still going. See, I end up almost making too wide a turn because it doesn't drive right. It doesn't. I'm turning my wheel still right now. There it won't. Just all of a sudden it jumps. It doesn't. I don't know. It just doesn't drive. I don't know if my wheels are off the ground. It almost might be that my wheels are. Like I'm wheelie in. But I don't like it. Alright, so let me see what else I got to do here. Well, you know, that other. I can get him back. Now, see, it's not driving too bad empty. It must be that it's not handling that load well. It still doesn't drive as smooth as that other Kenworth, but it's not as bad with an empty trailer. Yeah, I'll probably swap these out for the other Kenworth eventually. I got $2 million now. I think what I'm going to do with some of that money is I might buy some more farmland. All right, so I am purchasing, I'm purchasing young beefs and start filling. Here they come, young beef. Now, I've been told that if I leave one of the barns empty and use it for the slaughter weight beef, I don't know how that works. Do you still have to move them from barn to barn? I'm not quite sure if I understand what that meant, but... Yeah, I don't have the trouble driving the other Kenworth as I do in this one. This one just doesn't steer as well. I guess I'm lucky the traffic doesn't come around my farm. Goes on the outskirts. Right, if I'm not mistaken, I left off at barn number 4. There's 2. There's 3, so yeah, this one here. All right, let's let them do their thing. Get him out of the way. Now this one sure jumps too when you hit the accelerator though. It's got a lot of pep to it. I don't know if that's a good thing. Slow down. Damage mod. Be careful. Whoa. I think I missed the trigger. Came in a little too tight on that one, I think. There we go. Yeah, I had no idea it was going to take me this long to sell a little silage. But it's pretty much the whole episode. Selling silage. Isn't that something? Well, we got a little bit of animals purchased and delivered to the farm. I'm probably going to go ahead and finish selling the silage while there's still a sale. And then we can do something else on the next episode. But hey, we've made at least $1.5 million. I can't remember what I had when I started. I thought it was maybe about 600,000. I don't remember. Now we got two more barns to fill up with animals. And then I'm going to have to come over with some feed. Their feed's getting a little low. Now somebody asked me if they, or was telling me they had trouble getting fruit out of the mix. Yeah, I'm getting down. Oh man, I had a lot of silage. Anyway, somebody said they're having trouble getting rations out of the mixing station. I haven't had any trouble with that. I don't know what could be causing something like that. I mean, I would always check your mods, because somebody said they were having a problem with the map, and before I had a chance to even look into what they were having a problem with, they came back to me with a comment that said that they took all their mods out and worked just fine, and he started putting the mods back in one at a time until he could figure out which one was causing the problem. That is an issue with putting mods on, big issue. And that's why I, for each map I play, like Graceland, I have a folder that has the Graceland map in it, and it only has the mods that I'm going to use on Graceland. Nothing else. And what I do is I call that file or that folder Graceland. Now, when I'm playing Ringwood, I have a folder called Ringwood. And in that folder is the Ringwood map and only the mods that I'm going to be using in Ringwood. No others. And I've got maybe 10 farms that I'm playing. I only record a couple. I'm going to be recording two more though, so I'm going to have a total of four maps that I'm going to be playing, that I'm going to be recording. But each one has its own folder with a copy of the mods that I'm going to use on that map and the map itself. When I decide I'm going to play Ringwood, I grab the Ringwood folder and I rename it M-O-D-S, mods. And then when I start my game, it loads Ringwoods with all its mods. When I'm done playing Ringwoods, I rename the mods folder Ringwood. Now I don't have a mod folder now. There's no mod folder. There's just Ringwood and Graceland. Okay, then I'm going to play Graceland. I'll take the Graceland folder and I change it, I rename it to mods. Then the game sees the mods folder and loads Graceland. When I'm done playing Graceland, I rename the mods folder Graceland, and again, I no longer have a mods folder. That's how I do it. And then if I have an issue with a mod, it's gonna be on that particular map and no other. So it's a lot easier to keep track of mods being, causing problems with other mods. when you do it that way. Because if you keep putting mods in, and it's a mod that you're not using on that particular map, you don't need it. And it could be that it's influencing a different mod. So anyway, that's how I do it. Somebody told me, he said, well, I think there's a mod that'll manage those for you. I don't care. I like doing it my way. I'm used to it. And it just helps me keep all my, all my maps and games separate. And I know exactly what I'm going to get when I play Graceland. Exactly. So anyway, it's time to end the episode. Hope you had fun. If you did, give me a like, share it with a friend, subscribe if you haven't. And I'll see you on the farm in the next episode. Happy farming.